In an unfortunate event where we saw our favorite, or to some I will say their favorite, Mom Khize. Now, look, Mom Khize has, there's a dark cloud now hanging around Mom Khize, and allow me to explain why am I saying a dark cloud is hanging over that. I'm going to have to give you this because this is very important. So you're going to have to bear with me as we read this. Now, yesterday, I saw this as breaking news just when Ramaphosa was done speaking. And then this was the breaking news. Senior advocate, advocate Corette Naidu, or is it Naida, acting for SARS in a matter between Sean Mkhize, Mom Khize, Royal AM, and other business companies of Mom Khize, has been shot almost dead. Almost dead. But we know, look, so far we haven't heard whether she died or not. She was arriving at the hotel in Durban near Gateway Shopping Center. She was shot by a thug 3 times in her upper body, neck, and face. She is currently in ICU. SARS wants to attach all Mom Khize's fleet of luxurious vehicle, and Mom Khize's security team and armed guard first stopped the attorney from attaching this vehicle. The Hawks must intervene here. No thug is above the law. We know, okay, the tweet, because look, I read this because it's all over. Everybody knows about it. We know who wrote like this on Twitter, and I don't need to tell you that. They are already saying that Mom Khize is a thug, because that's the insinuation here, right? And just by reading the statement alone, there are a few things that doesn't make sense that I'm going to have to ask. Number one is, when she got shot, was she meeting Mom Khize, or it was after meeting Mom Khize? That's one. But even then, is it a crime? Has Mom Khize committed a crime by, I don't know. Is it a crime if a person gets shot while attending, or if the person is from you, or you, the person is visiting you? Is it a crime for the person to die before visiting you or after visiting you, right? You get what I'm trying to say? So we'll talk about that. But before we talk about that, is it a crime for people to do this? If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Before I can continue asking the relevant question that I have to ask here, and I'm going to ask, dark or blue, I am going to ask. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of the Commissioner for the South African Revenue Service, Edward Kweta, condemns this incident and said, let me read the statement according to them. They say, SARS call on law enforcement agencies to act in speed in pursuit and arresting those attempted to take a life of advocate Naira. SARS wishes Naira a speedy recovery and wish her family well. We will not be intimidated by such act of crime and cowardice. I don't know how to pronounce the name of this advocate, so please forgive me for butchering the surname. But Isars Yona is saying they wish her a speedy recovery, which I do too. Nobody deserves to die on this world. I think genuinely we must die when after sickness, and then when we have well spent our visit on planet Earth and we die naturally. We all want that. Speaking of us dying naturally, it's also very important for us to ask the questions. The incident is now being married to Mamkize, and the narrative is that Mamkize, but let's be fair, and I don't want us to behave like other people. I don't want us to reason like any other person. Yes, we might have suspicions, but now to start saying, "Hi, Mamkize, nah, man, we can't." Why I'm saying we can't do that? Simply because of a few things. Number one, this person was not shot by Mamkize, nor her security team, and therefore, it is wrong to create or to insinuate that Mamkize, you know what I'm saying? One, two. It is also, even if this person was from Mamkize, it is also wrong to insinuate that it was from Mamkize. It paints a picture and it creates a narrative that Mamkize got angry and it doesn't want to be investigated. You know what I mean? It creates such a narrative. And I don't think that it's the right thing to do at this moment. Another third point is something that we don't know. What if there were other things that she was dealing with? Highly classified matters that she was dealing with. We don't know. So I think the most sensible thing at this moment to do is to allow the police to do their work, allow the hawks to do their work, crack down the case. And then if Mamkize get arrested and get sentenced, she's a criminal. But right now, she can sue you for insinuating or saying that she's a criminal. She has a right to sue you because... honestly, people are dying every day. Why now do we make it look like just because they are dying, therefore it means, like for instance, taxi owners die every day after meeting different people. The people they met doesn't necessarily mean that they are now involved in their death. Not necessarily. So we don't know. Maybe she might have been followed because she's been dealing with other classified matters. But again, I make an example here. We heard of a doctor somewhere around Val who shot and killed a certain woman because they were divorcing, right? So they did not want to give each other the percentage that they were supposed to give each other. And because of that, they shot and killed that woman. So people die for different reasons. That's the point. And we can't say just because you die in this manner and therefore, no, that woman who I'm telling you about died in the manner that she died for a different thing, marriage. Because this one, in fact, as a spread view, for instance, we were once told, I was told a story by many people where a certain man was living with this woman. The man was okay financially. So they happens to go separate ways with this woman, and the woman wasn't going to get anything from this, right? Legally so. The woman gets angry, and that's the story that was related. The woman gets angry, hires people. This guy is at, there's a garage there at Sprayview. There are actually two garages there, same brand. This man is there, pouring petrol. He got shot right there. I'm saying an incident of that nature. We can't say just because it's a gun violence and therefore it means that it's a hit. This person was involved in business. We got to be told that this has got to do with the married life. So I'm saying at this moment we don't know what the cause until the police arrest people and sentence people. Then we shall conclude of the cause. I'm just afraid when we start making it look like Mamkize's thing.